Hello guys, welcome to another tutorial of Supreme Tuber. In this tutorial we will be discussing Routh Hurwitz stability criterion. Okay, so we will be discussing Routh Hurwitz criterion through a question by solving it. Okay, so the question is: using Routh criterion determines stability of the system given by the characteristic equation S raised to 3. Okay, this is the characteristic equation. I hope you all know what a characteristic equation is. Okay, I'll just tell you real quick what is the characteristic equation. Suppose you have a closed loop transfer function GS upon 1 plus GS by HS. Okay, so suppose this is your closed loop transfer function. So the denominator of the closed loop transfer function when equated to 0 becomes the characteristic equation. Okay, so whenever you are using Routh criteria, you always need to look at the characteristic equation. Here it is already given, so we will directly proceed with the Routh Hurwitz stability criterion. Okay, so before applying the Routh array, there are two necessary conditions which we need to check for the stability of the system. Those two conditions are, first condition is the coefficients of all the powers of S should be same, okay, and the second necessary condition is that all the powers of S should be present. That means if there is S5 is the highest power, then all the powers from S5 to S0 should be present in the characteristic equation, then only the system can be stable. Okay, it does not tell if it is stable or not, it just tells us that it is eligible to be stable. Okay, so now we have drawn the Routh array. So after drawing the Routh array, we simply proceed with putting the values. We only put the values for first two rows. Okay, so for S5 row we will put the value of coefficient of this, this and this, alternate coefficients, okay, starting from S5. So the first one is 1, the second one is 8, the third one is 7. Okay, for S raised to the power 4 we will put all the coefficients in alternate starting from S raised to the power 4. Okay, so first is 4, then 8, then 4. Okay, so I'll write it 4, 8, then 4. Okay, so now for filling the rest of the columns, we simply use a formula, which is, suppose you have to fill S3 column. Okay, S3 row. You look at this element, you multiply it with this element and this, and divide by 4, which means I'll write the formula. Wait, one second. It will be 4 into 8, okay, 4 into 8 minus 8 into 1 divided by this element, always this element, okay. Okay, so this will be equal to 4, 8, 4. This will be equal to 6, okay. So now for writing this value, okay, this value, as there is no space, I will write it a little bit here, but it still means that I am writing the value for column number 2. Okay, so for writing, for filling out this entry, we multiply 4 with 7, then subtract it with this. Okay, I will erase the previous arrow so that it won't confuse you. So it becomes something like this. So the equation will be 4 into 7 minus 4 into 1 divided by always this element, okay, 4, which is 28 minus 4, 24 by 4, again 6. Okay, this corresponds to column 2. Okay, I hope you are understanding because there is less space. Okay, so now for filling out this entry, okay, third entry of this row, okay, we simply multiply 4 by these elements. As there is no element, you can write 0 here. Okay, as there is no element, you can write 0. So first we take the arrow from here to 0 element. Second arrow goes from here to here and it is divided by 4. So 4 into 0 is 0. 0 into 1 is 0. Therefore this element is 0, or you don't need to write it. Okay. Now we will fill S2 row. Okay. For filling S2 row, we first need to fill this first element. For filling this element, we look at two rows above. Okay, then use that arrow technique which I just taught you. First put an arrow from here to here, then from here to here, and then apply the formula accordingly. Okay, so it becomes 6 times 8 6 times 8, I'll try to write a bit small, minus 6 into 4 divided by 6, which is 8 minus 4, which is 4. Okay. Now for filling out this element, we will again do the same technique. Take arrow from this element to this element. Then take a reverse arrow from this to this and divide by 6. Okay. So it becomes 6 times 4 minus 6 times 4, which is 0, divided by 6, okay, which is 0. I think I just made a mistake here. I have drawn the entire Routh array again here a bit clearly so that you can understand. So now we have to calculate this element. Okay, we have to calculate this element. Okay, what we will do is we will multiply 6 by 4, then we take an arrow again from this element to this element, okay, and divide by 6. Okay, so it will become 6 times 4 minus 0 times 4 divided by 6, okay, which is 4. Okay, and this element will there is nothing here, so this will be 0. Okay, if there are no rows, you can simply add 0 here, and 6 times 0 is 0, minus 0 times 4 is 0, so this is always 0. Okay, so now we have filled out S2 row also. Now we will try to fill out S1 row. For filling out S1 row, we again take the arrows, we again apply the formula, 4 times 6 minus 4 times 6, which is 0. Okay, so the first element is 0. Now for the next element, 4 times 0 is 0 and 0 times 6 is 0. Okay, so this element is also 0. You can calculate it using these formulas. This is very simple. Okay, this is like addition and subtraction. I'm not writing these things again and again. Okay, so as you can see, all the elements in the S1 row are 0. So the system is unstable. To find the number of roots lying in the right half of the S plane, we form an auxiliary equation A of S using the coefficients of S2 row, that is the row above the row of zeros. Okay, so as all the elements of S1 row are 0, we will form an auxiliary equation using the row above the 0 row. Okay, so the auxiliary equation is represented by A of S, which will be given by this row. Okay, this row. How auxiliary equation will be formed? You take the first element. Okay. You take the first element in this Routh array, okay, then write it here. Okay, then this element will be the coefficient of S square, because it is S square row. Okay, you take the next element by adding a plus sign, because it is plus 4. Okay, and the here and the power of S will be 0. Okay, you have to maintain a gap of 2 between powers. Like when I was writing these elements, I took alternate elements. That means I maintained a gap of 2 between the elements. Okay, so if I want to write the auxiliary equation, you have to maintain a gap of 2 between the powers of S. Okay, so I was writing the auxiliary equation for this element, for this row. This is S square row. Okay, so the first entry will be, so the first element will be S, will be in the terms of S square, and its coefficient will be the first entry of the Routh array. Okay, so the auxiliary equation is 4 of S square plus 4 S 0. Now you take the derivative of the auxiliary equation, that is D of AS with respect to DS. Okay, so the derivative will be 8 S1. This is a constant element, so this will be 0. Okay, now you replace the row of zeros by the elements of the first derivative of auxiliary equation and proceed with the formulation of Routh array. Okay, so we have got an S1 row. We have got an S1 element here. So we can put these elements in the S1 row and proceed with the formulation of Routh array. Okay, so I'll just make this column real quick. Okay, I have made the Routh array. All the elements will be same, okay, as it was here. Okay, so I'll write these elements again. You have to make the Routh array once again after you derive the derivative of the auxiliary equation. The elements are 1, 8, 7, 4, 8, 4. I'll write these elements here. Okay, I have written the elements in this Routh array. Now if I want to write the entries of S1 row, okay, here it were coming 0 0, okay, so here instead of 0 0 we will write 8 and 0, okay, 8 and 0. Why I am writing 8 and 0? Because they are the coefficients of the derivative of the auxiliary equation. Okay, so after now that I have the Routh array, once again we will proceed with the formulation of Routh array. Now we need to fill the S0 row. Okay, for filling the S0 row, we again use the same technique we have been using, which is 8 times 4 minus 0 times 4 divided by 8, which is 4. Okay, now for filling this element, this will be 0 because there are 0 elements here. Okay, so now the Routh array is complete. As all the elements of the first column of the revised Routh array, this is the revised Routh array, are positive, it indicates that there are no roots of the characteristic equation in the right half of the S plane. Okay, but still the system is unstable. Why? Because there was an all zero row occurring in the original Routh array, so the system is always unstable whenever there is an all zero row. But we proceed with the formulation of Routh array just to check if there are roots in the right half of the S plane. Okay, so now as you can see, all the coefficients are positive, therefore there are no roots on the right half of the S plane. So so still the system is unstable, so there must be roots on the imaginary axis of the S plane. Okay, the roots of the imaginary axis on the S plane can be found out by equating the auxiliary equation equal to 0. Okay, so for finding the roots on the imaginary axis, we will simply equate the auxiliary equation equal to 0. Why am I doing this? Look, the question is complete. Okay, in the question it was asked, determine stability of the system given by the characteristic equation. As soon as you found out that an all zero row has occurred, you can say that the system is unstable. But what you need to check is if the system is unstable or marginally unstable. Okay, if it is marginally unstable, the revised Routh array will not have any sign changes in the first column. Okay, if there are no sign changes, it indicates that there are no roots in the right half of the S plane. If there are no roots, and if there are no roots in the right half of the S plane, the system can't be unstable. Okay, but as there is an all zero row, it is marginally unstable. So now we will try to determine the values of the roots of S which are on the imaginary axis. For that we simply put the auxiliary equation equal to 0 and we get S equal to plus minus j. Okay, so these two roots are on the imaginary axis of the S plane. Okay, so the question is done. In conclusion, you can write this statement if it is asked in your exams. I'll write it. Okay, so guys, what I am about, this entire paragraph is the crux of the Routh stability criterion. You need to listen very, very carefully. This is the most important part. Okay, so as there was an all zero row in the original Routh array, the system was unstable, but we needed to check if the system was unstable or marginally stable. Therefore, we made a revised Routh array using the auxiliary equation and found that there are no roots in the right half of the S plane. Why there are no roots? Because the first column is all positive. There are no roots. Therefore, the system is marginally stable and has roots on the imaginary axis given by equating the auxiliary equation equal to 0. Okay, so you can pause the video and read it twice, thrice till it gets to your mind, because it is very, very important. Okay, I'll just hold the camera here so that you can pause the video. Okay, so if you like the video, do like, share, comment, subscribe to my channel. My channel is Supreme Tuber, and you can also follow me on Instagram. My Instagram username is saksham.slashjain. Okay, the link of my Instagram account is given in the description. Okay, so thank you guys for watching the video. Any doubts, post comment in the section. You can also give feedback on what topic should I make next video on. Okay, thank you guys.